Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining me. Here's a current update. What's going on at Yellowstone Super Volcano? A live view from the webcam there at Old Faithful. USGS has 24 earthquakes for the last week within this area of Yellowstone. The most recent, a 0.2 at Hedgen Lake and a 0.3 also at Hedgen Lake. 9.2 kilometers in depth. So that would be about 5 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. And this one, 8.8 kilometers. They have a 0.5 listed for yesterday. They only have it here as Wyoming. But it was near Little West Thumb. They also have a 1.4. Look like they got a small swarm of them that happened there. What else we got? A 0.8. That one also was yesterday. And then a 1.6. That was also yesterday. 4.5 kilometers in depth. A lot of these are 4.8. That was 5.8 and 4.5. So that would be 2.8 miles below sea level. That would probably be at the top of the roof of the upper magma chamber. The boreholes are not working, so I had to do with what I could get. Here we have Maple Creek. This one here is working. It's the borehole for the Madison River area. This one here is Chrome Mountain. I picked out the most recent earthquake that showed up on all three monitors. And this one is Lake Butte. It was interesting that Chrome Mountain had so many earthquakes marked in red, and I'm going to show you where that earthquake monitor is at. Here's Chrome Mountain. This is Montana. Right there. CRMT. Chrome Mountain, Montana. Now, down over here is the caldera for Yellowstone Lake. It is northeast, and that's the direction where the magma chamber is. Probably currently somewhere up in this area. But what is interesting also, they have an emergency mine shelter here. I don't know if it's because of their pond they have up there, or some other sort of disaster from a large earthquake, but here's an example of a refrigerator magnet that they have provided to local residents. Maybe because of all the mining operations that are going on there is why they have so many earthquakes. Here's one earthquake that was not reported on USGS at, about just before 11:49 Universal Time. That comes in as a magnitude 2.33. You see here we got a sharp jolt, another sharp jolt, and then it just kind of trails off. So it could be from mining. There is another earthquake at 13:51 Universal Time. This is Lake Butte. Here we have Crow Mountain. The borehole for the Madison River. And then another monitor for Madison River. This is not a borehole. So again, here's the signature and or the spectrogram. And we'll look at the signature. Yeah, I've talked about the popping of the rock. How as the ground gets fragile from the magma rising up, making the upper crust above the magma chamber very brittle. And we got a series of four. This may be able to break down into two right there. So at 5:56, USGS reports a magnitude 0.3. Here we got Maple Creek. This is the borehole for Maple Creek. And then we got Crow Mountain and Lake Butte. And we'll look at the signatures on all four. There you go. So here at Maple Creek, we have several in red. We're going to concentrate on this one right here. It actually comes in, let me bring this down so you can see it, as a magnitude 1.76. Not a 0.3. All right, let's go to the next one marked in red, which is this one right here at 610. I'll bring it up. There's the spectrogram. They are not reporting that one. And that one comes in as a magnitude 1.45. The next one marked in red, many of you that are new may not know that when they're marked in red, that means the computer picked up the earthquake, sent a message to the geologist that an earthquake occurred. The lighter the color, that's lines of melt. The darker the red, the hotter the gases that came up, or possibly magma. The first wave that came in is the P wave. That goes directly through the Earth. And then the second wave, which would be about right there, that is called the S wave, and that goes around the outside edge of the Earth. And that one comes in as a magnitude 1.63. There's a smaller one right there at 448. There's a spectrogram, and that one comes in as a magnitude 1.30. And we'll go back to the spectrogram, and I'll go back to the signature. That's the P wave right there at the beginning. The next one is the S wave. There is another earthquake 10 minutes before the 0.3 at 546. You can see it on all three monitors here. There's the spectrogram for Maple Creek. This is the spectrogram for the borehole for Maple Creek. This one here is Chrome Mountain. And this one here is Lake Butte. This would be what is called shallow volcanic tremors. You see these signature when a volcano is recharging for another eruption. There's a signature here. And this is an image from USGS showing the different types of earthquakes. You see there. Okay, we got also harmonic tremors here, surface events. Again, the shallow volcanic and the tectonic would be sharper tops. But this one is smoother. These are shallow harmonic tremors that are being picked up there at Maple Creek. And again, this is the line of melt. Not all rock melts at the same temperature. This here is a signature that came from the borehole of Maple Creek. And you can see the different little earthquakes that it picked up also there at the borehole. We got, probably two there. We got another one there. I'm going to have to make this bigger for you. There you go. And I'll bring it down a little bit. Yeah, this is all the activity that's been picked up there. And we'll go to the spectrogram when I pulled the files, what it was showing. Not too bad. Going back to Lake Butte, we'll look at some of the... Oh, it doesn't want to give me the data there. I hate that when it does that. Yeah, I don't know why sometimes the data doesn't come in. Sometimes I gotta wait hours upon hours for the data, but here at Lake Butte, you can see the line of melt when blobs of magma was coming in. I'll show you the signature. Yeah. And there. And we'll go over here. Yeah, that is their actual scientific term. Blobs of magma. Now, in the winter time, they do close down temporary monitors that are probably using solar or where they have to go out and download the data. But the boreholes are not temporary monitors. Here we have borehole 945, and you can see all the data that is missing. Borehole 206. And we'll make that one larger for you so I can show you that it's not working also. Has not been working for a while. Borehole 208. This is the monitor they have there at Yellowstone Lake. All right, and we'll go to another one for Grant. Hold on, right there. All right, right there. I'll make that one bigger. 944. That would be for Grant. So anyways, that's all I have for you right now. Yeah, just more of the same and slowly recharging. Yellowstone is so large, it's taking a very long time for the next eruption. Heaven help the world when it does decide to go. It has been recharging for about 6,000 years. And over here you can see the line of dead trees. These trees are dying from the roots up because of the gases coming up from the volcano. So any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for your support. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.